Hi everyone, Arturo Sprecaso here. Welcome back to another Sprecaso show. Before we begin, I'd like to remind everyone to please wear your masks at all times. I need you guys to be safe. Otherwise, who else is going to watch my videos, right? Anyways, guys, I'm going to take this quick moment to just give you a little breakdown of the stuff you're going to need for this next tutorial. You're going to need caulk, house caulk. Yeah, that's the secret to the 3D technique. We're not changing the media, we're modifying or adding an element to our medium, right? So we're going to be modifying the poster board, the foam board, the canvas, whatever it is that you guys use to spray paint on, that's what we're going to be modifying. So I've gotten a couple emails asking me if the layering is going to change the way we do the spray paint. Nothing changes, guys. All of those tutorials I have on YouTube, they all apply to this technique because we're going to be using those on top of the caulk. So, yep, that's the big secret. All right. So, like I said, this tutorial is going to be very basic, guys. So you're going to need just the basic equipment. Get your spray paints, masking tape. They usually come in a couple different sizes. I get the 1-inch and the 2-inch width. You're going to need a Sprecaso tool, not a palette knife, guys. I've painted for many years with oils and acrylics and pastels. And the palette knife worked great then, not for spray paint. The palette knife has a tendency to scratch the paint and not mix it. You need it to mix, guys. So if you don't have to buy the Sprecaso tool from me, you can, I got a couple tutorials and I can't think of the name right now, but you can go into those tutorials and it'll show you how to make one out of popsicle sticks. Get the thick popsicle sticks too. The Sprecaso funnel, I no longer sell the Sprecaso funnel. For those of you that have the plastic ones that I used to sell, that's great, bring it along. If you don't have one, there's a couple tutorials out there that show you how to make it with poster board and I think duct tape and a couple other materials. Anyways, those are very needed. I know a couple of you guys use a sheet that you fold, and the Sprecaso funnel has a tendency to last a little longer, and by little I mean a lot longer, and it holds a lot more paint. So, you know, go make a couple of those. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to use it on this next tutorial, but on the more advanced ones with the 3D techniques, we're definitely going to need it, guys. All right. Well, I think I covered everything. Please wear your masks, gloves. I know a couple of you guys are using some harsh chemicals to remove the paint from your hands. Wear some gloves, guys. You can go down to Walmart, a hardware store. They're very cheap. They come in a box of 100. Awesome. All right. Well, if I covered everything, I hope you guys are ready. Grab your spray paints, your mask. What do you guys say we go tackle this, huh? All right, here we go. All right, guys. Now, I'm using, it's almost like a shadow box, but not really. It's just a frame, but it's really thick, and it's got this little lip there on the bottom that holds my poster board in place. I recommend you look for these, especially if you're going to be using the 3D technique, and I'll tell you why later on. All right, you're going to need some white caulk, guys, as I mentioned in the introduction. And just get the white latex caulk. It's cheap. I think it was like a dollar. And we're going to use this to create and modify different textures on our poster board. And you don't have to have the frame on, guys. I'm just kind of showing you guys one of the beauties of being able to use this 3D technique is that if you ever decide, you can create the texture on your poster board and then overlap it onto your frame. You know, so you can make a tree branch stick out. You have to just color the tree branch later on. All right, so our first layer here is just some trees here on the background. And as you can tell, they don't really look like trees right now, but they will. Okay, spill up a little bit of caulk on there. If you ever, well, for more advanced techniques, we're gonna make sure we overlap some of our frames so it looks like the tree is actually coming out of the frame, or it looks like the flower has a stem sticking out, but that's later on, guys. All right, we're just gonna create a couple of trees here in the background. Now you're probably wondering why they're so different. Just like spray painting, guys, and I tell you about layers, you want different sizes and you don't want them all in one straight line. Remember that when you go outside and you take a look at just an open range, to say, you can see different trees at different lengths, at different widths, based on the distance that you're looking at. And you know, it depends also on the ground, how much curvature the ground has. So keep that in mind, guys. That's why I don't really put the trees in the same vanishing point, in the same line. You know, I modify it a little bit. Now, caulk very much like spray paint. Once it's dry, it's very hard to manipulate. So what I'm going to use here is my spraycastle tool, handy dandy spraycastle tool. And I am just going to give it the shape of wood. You're probably saying, how are you going to do that? Well, you don't have to use a spraycastle tool, guys. You can use your hands and you just shape it. Just sit there and shape it and modify it. And then go over it with either a little nail, or you know, if you do have a little spraycastle tool, go over it a couple of times, create the bark effect. You can create some knots, you know, pretty much. And I think in one of the future tutorials, I did a tree that has this really big knot and a little owl in the middle, so it looks pretty cool. It's one of the bigger paintings. But anyways, sorry, I get a little excited, guys, and I kind of tend to jump ahead and tell you about some of the future tutorials that are going to be coming out. Here, you may not look it, but I'll zoom in here in a little bit. I've already given the texture of trees to these trees here in the background. I've gone over them a couple of times, given them the bark texture. Now I'm going to create some ground. All right. I'm just going to add a little bit of caulk here. It doesn't matter if it's not very uniform, guys. I'm going to use my hands and I'm just going to smear it all together. You can create the terrain as rough as you want or as smooth as you want. Later on in more advanced tutorials, I'll show you how to create water. Yep, water. So you're going to have texture on your water as well. But as this is an introduction, I want you guys to get used to your medium here. Like everything, guys, it takes a little bit of practice. Okay, now, if you guys can see what I'm doing is, I added a lot of caulk here at the very top, and then I'm blending it into the painting itself. What I'm going for is I want it to look like the rocks themselves are kind of making like a small cliff, and the cliff is blending into the painting or into what's going to be the background. And you can add different layers, so you can have one side that's blending into the background and then a rock overlapping it. Okay, here we're just gonna smooth it out a little bit more. You don't want to leave the lines of the caulk. You know, it leaves very very straight lines. You want to, especially if you're going for the background look or the rocks, you want to mold it so that it looks like a rock. Later on, we're going to be experimenting with some molds. So we're going to make some molds. We're going to fill them up with caulk. You know, work on the background a little bit. Put the mold onto the painting. Lots to look forward to, guys. Right, we're gonna add a little bit of caulk here, just overlapping some of these rocks. Remember, guys, it doesn't have to be very neat. At the end, we're just gonna go over it with our finger, smooth it out. Here we go. Like I was telling you about these frames, they're not quite shadow boxes, and you can still find them in some thrift stores, Walmart. You know, stores like that where you can find a lot of frames. I actually go to garage sales quite often to buy frames. Or I tell, you know, friends and family members, hey, if you guys are ever out and about and you guys see some frames for cheap, you know, buy them, I'll pay you back. You know, I've often wondered how many times they bought them and just given me like the wrong price, you know, boosted up the sales, you know, 10%, 15%. I don't know. Either way, you know what? It's cheaper than buying the frame yourself. Okay, now here I'm just gonna add some more texture to the tree. This is one of the beauty. Okay, now check this out, guys. You see how I'm kind of overlapping the tree there at the bottom, the roots onto the frame? That's really cool. Imagine if you do a forest scenery and you start overlapping, you know, trees coming out of the frame. We have a lot of cool techniques and a lot of cool tutorials that are going to be coming out. Here what I'm doing is I'm just creating a little bit of rough texture, maybe some knots onto the tree. Of course, I'm going to use the funnels to color this in later on. as I was telling you about the frames, try and get them as cheap as you can, as you possibly can. Now I went ahead and I removed the frame, guys, only because I want to be able to move the painting around a little bit more. Now here with the tip of the caulk, I'm just creating, I don't know what to call it, little stubbles perhaps. This is going to represent tree leaves. Now this is not always how we're going to create our tree leaves, guys. This is a very beginner level technique, but you can definitely work it into a more intermediate, even advanced level technique. But for now, I just want to be able to have some rough texture where the leaves are going to be. We're even going to put some of this perhaps on the bottom, some scrubs or shrubs. Anyways, I'm going to keep going here. That was a joke. I have a friend that's a nurse, and we were looking for shrubs, and she kept calling it scrubs. And I think it's probably because that's what they call their uniforms, you know? Alright. Now I'm just gonna go over it quite a bit here in different areas of the trees. On the bottom, like I said, guys, you can add many different layers. Once you add a little bit of the stubble for the trees, you can go over it, add a tree branch that overlaps the stubble, and then add some more stubble on top of that. All right, let's keep doing. But this is just gonna be maybe 1-2 layer type of painting. I'm not gonna go into great detail yet. Okay, take a look at the trees and the terrain. Is it starting to form a picture of what it's gonna look like? Get your little stubble, your rocks. We're gonna add some water right here in this part. And all we have to do, guys, now is wait for it to dry. It's probably gonna take about 12 hours. That's about how much I waited on it. And then if you add your spray paint, one thing that I've noticed is that if you add your spray paint on top of this before it dries, it'll take much longer for it to dry. So it won't be dry to the touch. Believe me, that you'll touch and your finger will go right on in, and you'll be like, it's been 2 days, you know, what's going on here? Well, the spray paint will seal the caulk from drying. You actually need some air, you know, you need to let it vent out. So make sure you don't spray anything on it until it's completely dry, guys. All right, now here, I know that I'm gonna be working with my, with a sunset type of painting, and there's gonna be light. So I'm adding the layers underneath of what this light is gonna, you know, make our trees look like. So for our base colors, I'm using some orange and red. We're just gonna go throughout this whole painting. Now, the trees aren't gonna be, you know, completely red. We're gonna use the Spraycastle funnel to go over them and give it some texture. And then we're gonna add highlights. We're gonna add some lighting techniques. It's gonna be really cool. All right, now here, I'm just going over it with some more orange. I think the red was a little bit overpowering. So I'm gonna try and even it out a little bit, you know, just add some orange. A little bit of yellow. This is where our sun layer is gonna come in. This is gonna be, I guess I should have called it our light layer. Now notice what I'm doing here, guys. I sprayed on top, and since I know I'm gonna have water on the bottom, I'm gonna go ahead and add the reflection already. See that? So you have the sun on top, the sun on the bottom. A little bit of black. Okay. Now I call this the dream technique, guys. I use this a lot. You'll see me use it a lot in my some of my tutorials on YouTube. And what I do is I just go over the edges with a little bit of black, and then I fade it in or fade it out into the painting. All right, look at that. It's looking really nice. Alright, I think what I actually did here, guys, is I used a little bit of brown. Which, you know, you can still pull it off, but I'm still going to go over it with some black later on. Alright, now if you guys have the spray castle funnel, like I said, it's not super needed for you to get the plastic funnels that I used to sell. No, you can make your own. There's a couple of different tutorials that I got out here. They show you how to make it with duct tape. You can fix and make anything with duct tape, guys. As an engineer, let me tell you, it's a fact of life. All right, here I added a little bit of green to the stubble on top. This is where we're gonna start beginning to blend our colors together. I'm just gonna go ahead and add a little bit more yellow because some of that green covered our sun. Now, it's like a typical spray paint, right? You look at it and you're saying, okay, yeah, that's not gonna look like what I think it's gonna look. And then somehow at the end, it always looks amazing. So, you know, it is spray painting still, so don't give up on me, guys. We're gonna add a little bit of brown, some yellow, and this is what we're gonna use for our tree bark. All right, we're gonna add a little bit of that into our spray castle funnel. Now we're not gonna shake the funnel. We don't want the paintings, the spray paints to mix because then you'll get like a brown. You want them to swirl together. It will give you a swirly type of effect, which is really cool. Because if I was, you really can't see it here, but if you were to take a really close look at it, you could see the brown, and then you would see some yellow swirls, you know, throughout this tree. And you can do it with several paints. You can do it with black and yellow, and those look really awesome together. You can also add orange or red into the mix. And of course, the more colors you are, I wouldn't recommend you do over three. Three, I think, is pretty much the max. It's the magic number on spray painting. But anyways, you can do that, and your trees will look more unique, more advanced, more realistic. Of course, you can always add some off-the-wall colors in there and make them abstract. All right, so if you guys can't tell, the brown is soaking into the bark that we created. I added a little bit more brown into this. And now it's a matter of fact of just painting over the oranges, painting over the reds. I do intend on adding sun rays to this. So if you guys remember how to create sun rays, you get a straight edge. It could be even a flexible straight edge. Be able to create some sun rays hitting the trees. Those techniques still apply to this. Right. Now here, I added a little bit more yellow to the brown. So first I added a coat of dark brown. And now I'm adding a lighter brown to the mix. This will also give me the really realistic look. You know, so your trees aren't completely brown, right? So when you go outside, they have a little bit of yellow, they have a little bit of green, white. They have a combination of different colors depending on the light. So you don't want just solid brown trees, guys. Now here, I'm gonna add the effect that sun is hitting our tree. Yep, do you guys remember that light and dark technique? Well, it works just as good on the 3D part. You can also use white. I would use yellow first though, and then I would use white on top. Okay, now we're gonna create the effect of water here on the bottom. You guys know how to do that, right? There's many, many ways of creating water. There's very realistic looking water to just oil looking water. There's many techniques. The one that I'm using here is probably one of the quickest. I really enjoy it. just gonna add some blue. I'm gonna start mixing in some other colors like green into it. See here, I just added a few little straight edges, straight lines of blue. Now I'm just gonna kind of blend it in a little bit with some more blue. I'm not really worried if I get the rocks with the overspray. And this is something that I get a lot of emails on too. Is people asking me, do you change your tips? Because it kind of seems like you know how the spray is gonna come out. No, guys, I use the regular tips. I don't change anything to it. You know what happens is with practice. With practice, you'll learn to know how far you can spray your spray can, and you know what kind of damage it'll do or not. Now here I added a streak of yellow. Did you guys see me do that? Put it on one point, brought it down, added a little bit of white to break the straight line. Okay, I'm gonna work on that highlight technique on the tree just by adding a little bit more yellow, because I'm gonna add some sun streaks hitting this tree. So this is something that you wanna take under consideration too. It's always very, very important, guys, you know where your light source is coming from. Typical, I hate to say it, but typical noob mistake is you create a planet with the shadow on the right side and the sun on the right side. Yeah, you can't really do that. All right, here's the black. I'm just using that dream technique to it. Really love the way this is coming out. Now guys, this is just a beginner level 3D technique painting. Wait till we get more advanced. Here's the sun rays. As you guys know how to create that, right? I've done plenty of tutorials with that technique on there. Now whatever you do to the top, you want to do to the bottom. Remember, it's a reflection. So I added some highlights, some bright shining rays, so of course you're gonna add that to the bottom as well. Look at that. That is really cool. You know what else you could add to this painting to make it a little bit more realistic is highlights. Now I know we added a form of highlight, right? We added some yellow, but there's gonna be some areas that are gonna be brighter than the rest, and when you make them brighter, you're gonna want to add a little bit of white. If you want to get real technical, you start using the same color and then just adding white to it to make it look like it's getting brighter. But I don't want to overload you with the bunch of stuff. Just use white. It'll look better. Now I used white on the areas that the sun rays were coming through. You don't want to do the whole, you know, side of one tree white. Just the areas that are brighter, guys. Now I'm going to use the same technique that I've used on other spray paints before. Just get a little magazine sheet. I'm going to tap it into some yellow. And then I'm just going to add some highlights to this, to the rocky textures here. Look at that. Love it. I'm also trying to keep an eye out where these highlights are going to be. I know that the sun is hitting it in this particular angle. You know, you don't want to add highlights to the place where the sun is not shining through. So just a little bit of yellow, and you see how all those little textures help define the rocks more, the terrain more. Well, that's what you want. Later on, I'm gonna show you guys how to do roses, different types of flowers with this technique. What I'm doing here is I actually have a little bit of a sea sponge. I'm tapping it into some green, and I'm going over the little tree leaf stubble that we created earlier. I'm also going to add a little bit of yellow to this mix so that I can add highlights to this stubble as well. Now, because I added green at the beginning of the painting, you guys remember that when I just added green on top of the stubble? That helps in the illusion of making the tree leaves, you know, thicker, flusher. So all I'm doing here is just adding a little bit more to that, a little more texture to the background, so it's not just a flat spray. A little bit of yellow, I'm gonna add some highlights to, you know, some of that stubble. So the whole purpose of this is to make your paintings look more realistic. Now tell me this is not gonna take your techniques further. Now, of course it will. And I know you guys have great imagination. For those of you that don't know, you can find me on Facebook. I also have a group called the Spray Paint Masters Revolution, and I tell you what, man, those guys never cease to impress me. Some of the paintings that they're coming up with all the time, it's incredible. I love it. I love to see how this art is developing. You know, when I first started, it was nothing but space sceneries. Nothing but space sceneries. I was a bit of an outcast, started doing flowers, land terrain, and now look, now we're doing 3D. Yep, now this is just the beginning, guys. I have a lot more tutorials to come on the 3D technique. I know I introduced it, in a gallery, and then I started working on the DVDs, or the tutorials. This was going to be a full-blown DVD. But you know what? One of the things about Spraycasso, something that we've always done when we were on PBS, we believe in showing you guys free. You know, art should be free. It really should. Now, at one point, we had to sell our DVDs so that we could, you know, get time, so that we can buy time to record. And we had a bunch of expenses. But now, things have changed a little bit. And so I'm going to show you guys my techniques as I've always done, for free. Yay! Hey, I like free. I don't know about you guys, but I do. I love free. And art should be free. It really should. Okay. Now look at this. Now guys, this is the painting that we created using just one layer of 3D. One layer of caulk. We overlapped the ground a little bit, but that's not enough to call it a secondary layer. Technically it is, but I don't consider it. This is all just one layer. Start imagining if you start adding different layers to this. We want another tree branch to overlap this one. Okay, so you put your caulk down, you wait for it to dry, then you color it. But look at the dimension that you're going to be adding to your paintings. Okay. Ahead and sign it. I believe we are done with this painting. After this, guys, I brought you ground, earthbound paintings, flowers, 3D. I think the next step is to make it more realistic, huh? Maybe we can get some models and paint on them. Yeah, right. Wishful thinking. All right, guys. So I hope you guys have enjoyed today's tutorial. We're going to take a quick look at our finished product. Look at that. Little stubble, the rocks, the highlights, the reflection on the water. And for the next tutorial, you know what, guys, I should really have zoomed in a little bit more to these tree branches. But that's what it looks like with the frame on. And like I said, guys, you can really add some more stuff to it. You can couple more layers and you can have the trees coming out of this frame. I'll show you all that later. Alright, crew. Well, I hope you guys have enjoyed today's tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, you can either leave them here on my YouTube page or go to Facebook. Look me up. Arturo Spraycasso, Facebook.com. Alright, guys. You guys have a nice one. And until next time, keep those cans shaking.